Hi guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to share with you guys one of the engine basics, which is how to calculate the CC, the displacement of your engine. First, we need to understand some of the terms so that we can calculate it. What is CC stands for? CC is cubic centimeter, that means cm cube, okay, which is same as milliliter. Alright, so the second thing is we need to know from this rough sketch, this one is the diameter of the piston, and this one from the piston travels from the bottom dead center, goes to the top dead center. This one we call it the stroke. Simple maths, volume of a cylinder is just pi times d over 2 square, d is diameter of the piston, times stroke. Boom!
2 plus 2 is 4, minus 1, that's 3, quick maths.
So for 1JZ, the diameter of the piston is 86 mm, the stroke is 71.5 mm. But you need to be careful here because the CC is calculated in cm cube. That means cm times cm times cm. So all the mm we have to change to centimeters first. So over here you can see pi equals to 22 over 7, 3.14, okay, times bracket 8.6 cm converted to centimeters divided by 2. Alright, square times 7.15 cm, the stroke is also converted to cm. This one is for 1JZ. So we can get for one cylinder, it is just 415.5 cm cube. So there are six cylinders in JZ. So we times six, we can get 2492.98 cc, which is the same as slightly lower than 2.5 liters. Alright. So in 2JZ, the piston's diameter is the same, 86 mm, but the stroke is 86 mm too. So we convert everything into cm, we times 22 over 7 times 8.6 cm divided by 2, this whole thing square times 8.6 cm. So we can get slightly less than 500 cc, 499.76 cm cubed times 6. Six cylinders, we can get almost 3000 cc. Okay, we can also notice something. The piston is the same diameter, but the stroke for the 1JZ is 7.15, but the stroke for 2JZ is the same as the piston diameter. So what does it mean is, the piston diameter more than stroke, we call it as an oversquare engine. Okay, for these two, the piston diameter and the stroke is the same, so we call it as a square engine. Let's find out how they can get 3.4 liters out of those aftermarket billet crank with oversized piston. So what they use is, we use back the formula pi times, okay, the diameter is 87, just overbore by 1 mm square, times the height is 9.4 cm or 3.4 liter stroker kit. Let's see, can we get 3.4 or not? It is about 0.09 cc per cylinder. That means you can get 3,354. It is almost 3.4 liters, but it is as advertised as 3.4 liters stroker kit. Alright, so what can we get from high CC? Why we go after high CC? Okay, because high CC, high displacement, you can get higher amount of torque, higher horsepower, because it can get in more air, compress more air, and you can spray more fuel inside. That means you can get more horsepower and torque. Okay, and then the second thing we can get from this is Oversquare engine has higher maximum RPM. For 1GZ, the original maximum RPM is 7200 RPM or 7500 RPM. But for 2JZ, it's about 6800 RPM to 7200 RPM. In certain applications such as drift, we want to have very high RPM so that we can keep on pushing the car to continue to drift. So the Oversquare engine is very favorable in this situation. Okay, you know engines such as Ferrari, they all have Oversquare engines. And I also show you guys one of the engines from LFA. This engine can rev up to 9000 RPM very smoothly. And definitely we can get different sound from different types of engine. If it is an Oversquare engine, it sounds like a Ferrari. One more tip for you guys is, even though 1JZ piston diameter and 2JZ piston diameter is the same, but both of them are not interchangeable because of the height of the piston pin to the height to the top of the piston. So it's the piston. This one is the piston pin. The height from the piston pin to the top is different for 1JZ and 2JZ. So I hope you guys enjoyed this series, and I'm going to share with you guys more engine basics so you can understand more about JZ engines and your engines too. See you!
Press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos, and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building.